Now let us see the next graphical representation, a line graph. A line graph displays the data that changes continuously over periods of time. Now let us understand this with an example. So that when Renu, means a student, Renu fell sick, her doctor recorded her body temperature in the form of a table, and he took the temperature and recorded for every 4 hours from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. So at 6 a.m. her body temperature was 37 degrees centigrade, and at 10 a.m. 40 degrees centigrade, and at 2 p.m. 38 degrees centigrade, and at 6 p.m. 35 degrees centigrade. So for every 4 hours the temperature was recorded. Now let us draw the graph. So this is the time and temperature. So this graph is known as time temperature graph. Now we will take a horizontal line, which is also known as x-axis, and a vertical line, which is also known as y-axis. On the horizontal line, we will take the time, and on the vertical line, we will take the temperature in degrees. In degree centigrade. Now we will take the time on x-axis with equal intervals from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. So here 6 then here we will take 8 a.m. means 12 noon, 2 p.m. then 4 p.m. then 6 p.m. On the vertical line, means on the y-axis, we will take the temperature in degrees starting from 35, or we will take from 30, then 32, 34, 36, 38, 40, then 42. So on the y-axis we have taken the temperature in degrees centigrade. So the first one is 30 degrees centigrade, then 32 degrees centigrade, then 34 degrees centigrade, up to 42 degrees centigrade. So here we are not taking from 0 to 6, so that is why we have to represent it by a jog line. And here also from 0 to 30 we are not showing, so here also a jog line. Then now we will plot the points representing the temperature at equal time intervals. So at 6 a.m. her body temperature is 37 degrees centigrade. So at 6 a.m. her body temperature is recorded as 37 degrees centigrade. So here, so this point represents her body temperature at 6 a.m. means 37 degrees centigrade means between 36 and 38. So then at 10 a.m. her body temperature is 40 degrees centigrade. So let us represent her body temperature at 10 a.m. So it is 40 degrees centigrade. So this is our body temperature at 10 a.m. The next At 2 pm, her body temperature was 38 degrees centigrade. At 2 pm, 38 degrees centigrade. So this point represents that her body temperature at 2 pm was 38 degrees centigrade. Next, at 6 pm, 35 degrees centigrade is the body temperature. So at 6 pm, you will show it by 35. So between 34 and 36, so it is 35. Now, if you join all these points, then we get the line graph. So in this case, this is also known as time temperature graph, because we are taking time on horizontal line and temperature on vertical line. And if you observe the pattern of the temperature, so from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. it was increasing. Then from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. it was decreasing. So from, see in the table also you can see that from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. the temperature was increasing from 37 to 40 degrees centigrade. And since then it was decreasing. So from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. it was decreasing. So 40 to 38, then 38 to 35. Now if you want to find the temperature at 8 a.m. actually, it is not given in the table, it was not recorded. So if you want to find the temperature at 8 a.m. so then we can find the temperature at 8 a.m. from the graph. So if you draw a vertical line from 8 a.m. so definitely it is more than 37, because from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. the temperature was increasing. So at 8 a.m. also the temperature will be more than 37. So approximately it may be 38 or 39. So we can say that here the temperature at 8 a.m. is 38 degrees centigrade. So again at 10 a.m. the temperature was 40 degrees centigrade, and from 10 a.m. the temperature was decreasing. So this is the time temperature graph, means it is a line graph. So a line graph displays the data that changes continuously over periods of time. Here the data is changing continuously over periods of time. So when you take the time on horizontal line, so over the periods of this time, means from 6 a.m. to 8 a.m., from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m., from 10 a.m. to 12 noon, so the data is changing continuously over the periods of time. So far we have discussed regarding the bar graph, double bar graph, and pie chart, means pie graph, and histogram, then line graph. Now let us solve some problems. The question: the following graph shows the temperature of a patient in a hospital recorded every hour. So on the horizontal line the time is taken from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. on the vertical line, means on the y-axis, the temperature was taken in degree centigrade. Now at 9 a.m. the patient's temperature was 35.5 degree centigrade, and at 10 a.m. 36 degree centigrade. So up to 3 p.m. the temperature was recorded. Now let us answer the following questions. So what was the patient's temperature at 1 p.m.? So at 1 p.m. we have to find the patient's temperature. So draw a vertical line from 1 p.m. it meets the line graph at 36.5 degrees centigrade. So the patient's temperature, and if you draw horizontal line from 36 point, from the point where it meets the line graph, so it is 36.5 degrees centigrade. So the temperature at 1 p.m. was 36.5 degrees centigrade. Now the second question is, when was the patient's temperature 38.5 degrees centigrade? So the patient's temperature 38.5 degrees centigrade is given here. So the from here if you draw the vertical line, so then it will meet the horizontal line at 12 noon. So that patient's temperature was 38.5 degrees centigrade at 12 noon. So we can write the answer as 12 noon. Now the next question, what was the temperature at 1:30 p.m.? So after 1 o'clock means after 1 p.m. So between 1 and 2, if you observe the line graph from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m., so there is no change in the patient's temperature because from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m., so it is constant, there is constant temperature. So at 1 p.m. 36.5 degrees centigrade, and even at 2 p.m. also 36.5 degrees centigrade. So this straight line means horizontal line represents that there is no change in the patient's temperature from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. So we can understand that at 1:30 p.m. so between 1 and 2, so at 1:30 p.m. also the patient's temperature is same as 36.5 degrees centigrade. So that patient's temperature at 1:30 p.m. is 36.5 degrees centigrade. Now the next question, the patient's temperature was the same two times during the period given. What were these two times? So the patient's temperature was same two times, so at 1 p.m. and at 2 p.m. So at these two times the patient's temperature was the same. Now see the next question. During which periods did the patient's temperature showed an upward trend? Upward trend means the temperature increases. So from 9 a.m. to 10 p.m. 10 a.m. from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. the temperature increases, and again from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. also the temperature increases. So and since then the temperature was decreasing. So from 11 a.m. to 12 noon, and again from 12 noon to 1 p.m. also the temperature decreases, and from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. the temperature is same, and again from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. the temperature increases. So there are three time intervals where the temperature increases. So from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. Next, 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. The next case is 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. Let us see the next question. The following graph shows the yearly sales figures for a manufacturing company. So on the horizontal line the different years are taken, and the vertical line sales in rupees crores. Now let us answer the questions. So what were the sales in 2002, 2003, 2005 and 2006? So in 2002, from the line graph you can say that so the total sales was 4 crores. So in 2002, if you draw the vertical line from this point, and we can see that the total sales in 2002 was 4 crores. Next, 2003. So in 2003, from the graph, from the line graph, we can say that so between 6 and 8, so that is 7. So there are 7 crores rupees sales in the 2003. Next, in the 2005. So in 2005, so this horizontal line meets the vertical line at 10. So we can say that 10 crores rupees in 2005. So 10 crores rupees of sale in 2005. Next in 2006. So in 2006, so 8 crores rupees. Next, compute the difference between the sales in 2002 and 2006. So in 2006, 8 crores rupees, and in 2002, 4 crores rupees. So 8 crores minus 4 crores equals to 4 crores. Now the next question, in which year was there the greatest difference between the sales as compared to its previous year? So when you compare 2002 to 2003, so the sales difference was here 4 crores in 2002 and 7 crores in 2003. So 4 here and 7. So then the difference is 7 minus 4 is 3 crores. But when you compare 2004 to 2005, so the sales in 2004 was 6 crores and sales in 2005 was 10 crores. So then 10 minus 6 is 4 crores. So the difference between these 2 years is 3 crores, and the difference between these 2 years, 2004 and 2005, is 4 crores. So this was the more difference when compared to this difference. So in 2005, in the year 2005, so there was the greatest difference between the sales as compared to the previous year. So we can write the answer 2005. So in this year 2005, there was the greatest difference between the sales when compared to the previous year.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.